Hello everyone and welcome back to another tutorial video, and today we are in Google Sheets and I am going to be talking all about charts within Google Sheets. So there's lots of times when you have groups of data and you would like to better visually see it kind of in a condensed form, and obviously charts are a great option for doing so. So as you can see here in one of my sample spreadsheets here, we have some fitness data over here. We have like some weight, we have some exercise numbers and some miles walked or ran, whatever you want to call it over here. And we've created a fitness tracker chart here that goes ahead and manages in a bar graph and then a line graph. So we can do a bunch of different things here, and we'll walk you through how to add a legend, a title, and how to customize all of your charts to your liking. So if we hop over to our tutorial worksheet here, I am going to make it a little more aesthetically pleasing just for my sake here. So I'm going to go ahead and add some alternating colors. And then what I'm going to do is show you first and foremost, how do we insert a chart or a graph, whatever you want to call it, into our Google Sheets project. So the first thing we could do here is we could select an empty cell. And then if we go up to insert and then go to chart, you're going to see there is no data. So obviously that's not what we want to do. We want to select and highlight the data in which we want to be included inside the chart here within Google Sheets. So select and highlight or hover over the information or data you want to include in the chart. Now if we go up to insert and then go to chart right here, we are going to see a nice little chart designed for us here. We can click and hold. We can adjust the location of that chart by just clicking and holding and moving that anywhere on the spreadsheet. We can also click the corners and edges of the chart, and we can either bring in or out to increase or decrease the size of the chart. As you can see, from the information that we highlighted and provided to Google Sheets, it went ahead and said, okay, the numerical data here is going to be what we want to track inside the chart. And then the names over here on the side is, you know, maybe going to be like what the revenue source is or whatever it may be. It's kind of letting you know that, hey, this is a way that we can do this. Now, I'm going to show you another way to create a chart that can go ahead and fine tune exactly what you may want to be inside the chart. So if we go to insert here and then go to chart, as you can see, there's no data here. But what we're going to do here on our chart editor or the setup options here is you can see we had the chart type, and we'll talk all about that, you know, very soon. But what I want you to do and notate is the data range. If we go to data range here and click on select data range, it allows you to open up a select data range box here, and we can just go over here and select all of the data ranges where we want to include into this chart. Once we do that, we go to OK, and then obviously you could insert that data manually. So once you've selected your data, you have your data range selected here, there's a bunch of different things that we can do. I'm going to zoom out so we can see the full kind of top-down view of what we're doing as we are changing and editing this chart. So here we go. Under setup here, we're going to go from top to bottom. First, we have our chart type. We have column chart is going to be what's auto-selected, but we obviously can go here and select a bunch of different types of charts. Now, these should be fairly familiar to you, and depending on the data set you're working with and your preference, you're going to either choose a line chart, and again, anytime you click on that, it's going to change it, maybe an area chart here, maybe a column chart, something that you want to look good, whatever you want it to look like here. Again, all of this is just customizing how you want your chart to look. Maybe you want a horizontal bar chart, showing you the data here left to right. Again, all of this is going to be preferential, and it's going to be, again, what you want for your data set. Now, for the purposes of this video, I'm going to choose a pie chart, which is what you see here on the screen. So we have our chart type here, and we can customize how it looks and the colors and the different legend attributes and things like that, and we'll do it very shortly. Now, we're going to see here label and value. Now, a label is going to be what you see here, the names like Drew, David, Lily, Jane. Those are going to be our labels. So that's going to be column one there. Now, again, Google Sheets went ahead and did this for me because they kind of said, oh, here's a name and a number. These are going to be the labels, and then the numbers will be the values. Okay, you can change this. So if you want the label to be something else, you obviously select into the three dots here and you go to remove. And then you just click into here and you can open up this right here and again, select the information that you want to be the labels. all of this can be changed. All of this can be, again, custom made or tailored for your specific chart or spreadsheet. So once we have our labels, we'll then have our value. Now, the value is going to be the data that we're trying to monitor or see visually here within our chart. So what we want to do here is value the same thing. We can either remove that or select into that and go ahead and select that data range manually, or it should have done it for us once we've created the chart. Next, we'll see something that says switch rows and columns. Now, the only reason you'd want to do this is if you had, like, say, a column or bar graph. So we go to column here, and then we go to switch rows or columns. Again, it'll change it to, it'll basically reverse what it had already done. Now, normally what I would say is that you leave that unchecked unless you have a reason for that, right? Use row one as a header. So basically, if this is a header up here, so let's say we inserted a row. So we insert one row above, and we have a header here. We'll say, we'll just title it header, okay? That will not include this into our chart, right? So it's going to exclude that if we have a header above. So again, those are all things that we can do. Also, you can double click on your chart to edit at any time. Very simple. We can do that there. We can add a header or not. That's really up to you. Under setup, that's really all we have. Now we're going into customize, which is the right hand column here. And we're going to have a bunch of different things. We'll go through them one by one. Chart style. This is going to be the aesthetics of your chart. If you are a visual person like me, you may want to play around and change like the background color. You can do that. You can even change the border color if you want to, and that'll change kind of the border around that color. Again, all of this is really up to you, what you may want it to do. And again, any of these options here, you can make it 3D, you can make it into a compare model, you can make it a maximized model here, and you can even reset if you've made some changes and you're like, oh, that just doesn't look good. And then under font, very self-explanatory, you can change and select the font that you want to use within your chart. Now, for the visual purposes of this, I'm going to change this back over to a pie chart just because I like the way that looks. All right, now with a pie chart, also something to note, you're going to have different customizable options depending on the type of chart or graph that you're working with. So as you can see here, I have some pie chart specific customized options. If I go to setup and change this over to a bar chart and go to customize, you're going to see I have a number of different things that I can change. So what I'm going to do now is look here where it says chart and axis titles. This is going to be where you can go and you can add kind of the titles over here, kind of where they're located, as well as if you go to subtitle here, you can even give the chart a subtitle. So as you can see, my chart does not have a title, but if I want to give it one, you can see now, boom, it has a title and I can adjust that at any time. All of these things are fairly self-explanatory. I just want to walk you through them as we're looking at them so you kind of get a better view of what you may want to do for your said chart or graph. Next, we'll have series. Now, what are series? Now, series are going to be what you see here, the blue bars, as you can see. All right, so as you can see here, I went ahead and added another data set down below here. If I go back into my chart here, what we can do, if you have two different data sets that you're trying to compare and contrast, if we go back to setup here, you can see that we have the series here, which is this information here. But if we want to add another series of data or a set of data to compare and look at, we go to add series here. Go back to click the little graph here, and then you would just select the range. So we'll go here and we'll select the range. Basically, we'll do this data here and we'll go to OK. And now, as you can see, we have a different set of data to compare. It's a different color. And again, this is the main reasons why you're going to use charts or graphs is to compare and contrast data points, right? So if we go into back into here into our customize option here and we go to series, you can see that we'll have different options to choose and add different data points for said series, right? The legend. What is a legend? If we go into legend here, the position of the legend is auto. It makes it look better. The legend is over here. If we go to top here, this chart doesn't really have a legend. But if we go here and we change this over to a pie chart and go to customize legend, you can see our legend is up here. The legend is going to be what shows you what the data, points are, like what they stand for. Like this is the person's name. Susan is red. Jane is yellow. That's basically what your legend is. If we change it to bottom, it shows up down here. If we change it to left, it shows up over here. Again, all of that information will be dependent on what type of information you're working with and the type of chart that you went with, right? So we're going to go here and change our chart back to bar. Back under customization here, we'll move from legend and we'll go to horizontal and vertical axes. Now, obviously the horizontal axis, right, is going to be this guy here. Boom. The vertical axis is going to be what goes up and down. That's fairly self-explanatory, right? And we can change that information. So this is going to be how this data or how this information looks. So how the names look. So under the on the vertical axis, we go to label font, and we can change that to wide. You can see it went ahead and changed the font on the side. I'll undo that now. And we could even make it bold and italicize if we want to. This is just changing what's on your vertical axis. And then if we go to the horizontal axis, it's going to obviously change what is on the horizontal axis down here at the bottom. All of that's pretty self-explanatory. Any customizations you want to make to the horizontal and vertical axes will be done here on the right-hand side. Now, grid lines and ticks. Now, vertical axis or horizontal axis. This is going to be basically how you want it to show. Do you want it to count up or over, right? And then again, this is going to be applicable to only a certain number of, say, types of charts. So if we go to pie chart here, go to customize, and then we can kind of see that it's not even on that list over there. So again, as I mentioned earlier, it's really going to be dependent on what type of chart that you use. So we'll go back to our bar chart here, go back to customize. And a couple of last things that I want to say before we close out today is that, again, remember, you can always move and resize after you've worked on and created your chart or graph. You can click and hold and drag that anywhere you want. And you can at any time, once you change data, so if we go in here and we change that number to, say, 600, you can see it makes the change to that graph. We change this number right here to, say, 555. You can see it changes that there. Again, everything works if you are, you know, if you have a formula, and let's just say you've added up all of this information here in the data. So if we go to equal sum, we'll go from that there. It gives you the total number there. If you want to include that, you know, later on down the line into your graph, you can just double click here. And you can go to setup, and then as you can see, you'll have your different series here. We're going to change it from, you know, to this series here, and we'll kind of click into that there. And we can always remove that, and then we'll add the new data points there. Go to OK, and as you can see, that is now added into your graph. So at any time, you can add data points, remove them, change the way the graph looks, customize it any way you want, and you are good to go. If you ever want to copy a chart or a graph, all you have to do is select that there and then Command or Control C. And then we go over here, Command, Control V, and that will paste the same chart right there. It doesn't work as a lot of things do in Google Sheets where it's kind of a stationary to a specific cell, a column or row. This is kind of a separate, kind of above the actual spreadsheet, right? And then if you want to delete or remove it, you just select it there, hit backspace or delete on your keyboard, and it is removed. That's it. That's everything you need to know to get started about charts within Google Sheets. If you have any questions, please put those in the comment section below, and I will see you guys in the next video.